Think like a man.
Like us. Follow us. Because I said so.
Like a trucker, nice thighs, nice waist, and you know I can't forget about your face. But don't none of that matter. I'm about to make your pockets better. And I just wanna see you feel right now, 'cause it's late. And I just wanna see you feel right. Taking time, I'm with it. And I just wanna see you feel right.
In the circumstances that you're experiencing. You have a man who's not committing and showing you how you, rather than the blame game, which is usually what occurs, it doesn't really resolve much, this book actually gives you insight to the way you may be contributing to your circumstances. And so does this movie.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, my question is for Kevin Hart. I have a question for you.
I'll take it.
Since that you always have, you know, humorous roles and things like that, what roles in the future do you see yourself playing, like, i.e. serial killer, etc., more serious roles? How do you see that?
Like the passenger 57, like once he slams man. like Samuel L. Jackson, the snakes on the plane. you know, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Action Jackson, but just things that require me to take my shirt off. There's a lot of nudity coming in my career.
This question is for Romani Malco.
I'm out.
We loved you in Weeds. What's your favorite role of your career?
My favorite role of my career thus far. Have to be Think Like a Man. Outstanding role, and you know what? You can put this in the press. I'm as proud of this role as I am of my role of 40-year-old virgin, and I'm as proud of this movie as I am of 40-year-old virgin.
Yes, family here.
What?
This is for anyone who likes to dance.
Okay. Terrence.
Okay. Usually, this movie will portray a positive light on black relationships as it relates to how we are represented in the media.
Absolutely. I think if you took us out and placed any other cast, if you took the cast from The Hangover and replaced us, the film is so good, it crosses all boundaries. It's not about racism. It's not a black film. This is just a good film. This is a classic movie. I think it hits on you know, this is the funniest cast I've ever seen together, and this is probably the most important relationship movie of our generation. I think that, you know, film defines our definition of love. When you watch, you know, great romantic comedies or great, you know, romance stories, period, it defines how you look at love. And this film does that for our entire generation. It's a classic.
More than think like women. And my reason for that is I just feel like women are so emotional. And if you hear the complaint from our guys, it's that we're too emotional. And one thing I learned from this movie and from reading the book is to not be so emotional and not act off emotion. Take a minute, process, and then react. So I don't think anyone should necessarily write that book, because I think this book is the key to keeping y'all in line the way we do. Okay, right here, young lady here.
So we love you.
Yes. Hi, guys.
Maybe. Y'all should let one white girl ask a question. Damn.
I think there's only one of us here.
Okay, Siobhan. The situation is men don't know the real reasons. Don't know the real secret behind, you know, why women act the way they do. Nor do women know the real reason why women act the way they do. But what do you think is the biggest misconception that about men and vice versa?
Biggest
misconception.
That's a big word for him, honey. Can you? No, so that he can understand.
Here's the thing. Okay. I'm gonna take the salt and I'm gonna sprinkle it on the situation.
I can't deal with it.
You want to be happy. You want to have a good relationship. Be a realist. Okay, by realist that means understand that people are human. People make mistakes. All mistakes aren't on purpose. All mistakes aren't intentional. With that being said, thank you. With that being said, for me, I just think it's an understanding the way the man thinks. Like that word, will you let me?
Because I'm flipping that again.
I'm flipping it into what I want it to be. Okay. I want y'all to be. Back to me breaking it down. Okay. Being a realist and understanding that, hey, we're not perfect. We do dumb things. When a woman grasps and understands that, then you're able to put up with stuff. Then say, you know what? Even if he's not doing what he's supposed to, I can do what I'm supposed to. And me doing what I'm supposed to is going to make him realize that, hey, you're going to lose something that's possibly going to hurt you. And if you lose this, it's not a chance you might get it back. Now that means I got to say, hey, I'm not doing what I'm supposed to. I'm not doing what I'm supposed
to. Yo, can I throw an answer? I think that one of the biggest misconceptions between men and women is that men underestimate how much like men women can actually be. And I think that women underestimate how emotional men can actually be.
Thank you. You know what was interesting is for each character, it's like I read the script over and over again. Not to break down what each character was going to wear and
everything.
So
thank you.
Of course,
Brian.
But
his name is Self-Love.
Thank you,
Self. Or Regina.
Are in long-term relationships, what would you say?
Now that felt directed against me. No. I don't know if it was, but you said for those who, so who do you just want to say, just not Regina? Can I just share that to people in relationships?
Well, what I want to ask is, what is one thing that you've taken from this film and the book in your personal relationship?
Never let your man go to the strip club. No. I just take that in relationships, it's about communication and understanding, and books and friends can give you guidelines and tips, but you gotta find out what works in your relationship, and that's what works for you. I mean, I was engaged for 6 years and everybody thought I was the craziest, stupidest person on earth, but it worked for me and my husband, and now we've been together for 8 years. You gotta do what works for you.